That means in place of carbon, write beryllium. Here, boron. Here, carbon. Here, nitrogen. Now, write a IE1 order for these elements, which are obtained by decreasing 2 units from the given elements. So, what is beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen? IE1 order, boron less than, beryllium less than, carbon less than, nitrogen. This is the order. Okay. Now, what is IE3 order of the given elements? You know, removal of one electron from these elements gives the same electronic species when 2 electrons are removed from these species. So, removal, sorry, 3 electrons. Removal of 3 electrons from this. So, removal of 3 electrons gives what? C plus 3. You know, C plus 3, Be plus 1 contains same number of electrons. Be plus 1 means 3 electrons. C plus 3 also 3 electrons. That's why IE1 order of these elements equals to IE3 order of the respective elements. So, boron is taken in place of nitrogen. So, write nitrogen here. Beryllium in place of carbon. Carbon in place of oxygen. Nitrogen in place of fluorine. This is the IE3 order. So, in that way, we can determine IE1, IE2, IE3. First, you have to remember IE1 order for second period or third period elements. Both second period and third period elements. You have to remember the IE1 order. Then you can answer IE2 or IE3 for the IE3 order for the given elements in this way. Got it? Next, there is a graph showing the ionization energies and atomic numbers. See the graph drawn between ionization energy values in electron volts per atom along y-axis, atomic number value along z-axis. Here the values are so in this case, this is the nature of the graph. In this case, see the peaks are occupied by noble gases. Dips are occupied by alkali metals. There is decreasing trend from lithium to rubidium. So lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Ionization energy decreasing trend. Here also, from helium to xenon, decreasing trend. So this is ionization energy versus atomic number graph. In this, a graph with peaks and dips are formed. The maxima are occupied by noble gases. The minima are occupied by alkali metals. Okay. So finally, there is a topic, ionization enthalpy. What is that? Ionization. Is ionization energy, ionization enthalpy same? Not same. Let's see the difference between them. Ionization energy and ionization potentials are same. What is ionization energy reaction? Ionization energy reaction M in gaseous state plus, use raised to electron plus M plus gas. Okay, this is the reaction. for first ionization energy. Okay, you know this is a chemical reaction. For this chemical reaction, how to write the enthalpy of reaction? You know, enthalpy of reaction at T Kelvin is equal to enthalpy of reaction at 0 Kelvin plus integral of 0 to T delta Cp naught into dt. That is the relation. Here, what is delta RH naught at T Kelvin? It is at 0 Kelvin. You know, ionization energy, the word is defined at only 0 Kelvin. Initially, I said that ionization energy is the energy required to remove an electron from the valence shell of neutral, isolated, gaseous atom at 0 Kelvin. So here, at T Kelvin, we call it as ionization enthalpy. At 0 Kelvin, we use the word ionization energy, but at T Kelvin, we use ionization enthalpy. You know, this is ionization enthalpy. So, ionization enthalpy here formula is ionization enthalpy equals to ionization energy plus integral of 0 to T delta Cp naught plus into dt. Ionization energy means it is the energy at 0 Kelvin. Ionization enthalpy means it is the energy at T Kelvin. Both are same meaning. But both are energies required to remove the electron. But this is the ionization energy at 0 Kelvin. But ionization enthalpy is defined at T Kelvin. So here ionization enthalpy is equal to, here short form IE plus. What is this value? You know, in this integral dt means T. So this is a constant term. Delta Cp, how to get? Delta Cp from the reaction we get. From each species in this, because monoatomic all are. That's why, you know, for a monoatomic Cp value is 5 by 2 R. Cp value for each monoatomic species 5 by 2 R. So 5 by 2 R, 5 by 2 R, 5 by 2 R. That means delta Cp, how to get? Delta Cp naught means 5 by 2 R plus 5 by 2 R minus 5 by 2 R. That means finally delta Cp value 5 by 2 R integral of dt. Integral of dt means T with limits T 0. Na? So it is T with limits 0 and T. So how to write? T minus 0 means T. So finally we got the value 5 by 2 R T. So this we use for the calculation of ionization enthalpy at a different temperature. So ionization enthalpy equals to ionization energy plus this delta Cp naught dt. Okay, so both are energies required to remove the electron, but ionization energy is the energy required at 0 Kelvin. Ionization enthalpy is, it is energy required at T Kelvin. T means certain temperature. So this is all about ionization energy.